Hello everyone. Now let's talk about the definitions which are been given as per your Consumer Protection Act of 1986. Next definition is very important when it comes to your understanding your what do you term by the unfair trade practices, that is as per section 21R. Now unfair trade practices can also be called to be as a trade practices for the purpose of promoting or for the purpose of sale or use of supply of goods for the provision of any other services where we are using such kind of deceptive practices or kind of activities where we will increase the sale and all, that can be called to be as unfair trade practices. Any adulterate supplying of the adulterated goods, selling of your wrong quality of products, the default in the quantity of the goods, all these can be called to be as your unfair trade practices, where because of such activities the other parties are going to, the purchaser, the consumers are going to feel suffocated, they are going to feel some kind of harm to their activities and the goods, then it is called to be as your unfair trade practices. In your when we are talking about your unfair trade practice, it also includes where we are purposely doing the advertisement where we are degrading the other particular manufacturer's goods and purposely defeating the value of the other products, other manufacturers, other competitors, even that can be called to be as your unfair trade practices. Manufacturing the surface goods which is having hazardous effects on the health of the people, even that is going to be called to be as a unfair trade practice. Now coming to the last part of your Consumer Protection Act, that is your counsel. Now this plays a very important role when we are understanding the counsels. There are three counsels which we have to understand in a very much broader manner, in very much in-depth manner, because these are only the counsels who are going to help us or help you out for any such kind of issues. Now in that council we are having District Consumer Protection Council, it can also be called as District Council, State Consumer Protection Council, it can also be called as State Council, or National Consumer Protection Council, it can be also called as National Council. Now let's understand in this part of what and how this particular council works. Now first of all, every district is required to have a district council. So that means to say every district is going to have its own district, so that if a particular consumer, they want to file a case against them, they can easily file it out. Now this district council is being set up by the state government. The state government is going to appoint a particular district council in their particular every district. Now this particular district council is going to have a collector, and this collector shall be the collector of the district and shall be the chairperson of that particular district council. So he is going to be the collector of that particular district, at the same time he is going to be a district chairperson for the district council. And he is going to have such number of persons and such number of members or officials as representing his members for the functioning and as representing the state government for the smooth functioning of the your district council. Now the council is required to have a meeting. Now this meeting is required to be as and when minimum 2 meetings should be held in a year, and as and when required by the particular chairperson, that is for collector, or the members as required importance of that particular case. But at least twice in a year you are required to meet. Now when you are going to meet, the resolution is being passed by the council are only recommendatory. The statement, the particular order which is being passed by this country, that is your council of district council, will be called as a recommendatory. It is not going to be a kind of a judgment, but it is going to be kind of a recommendation which is going to be given by them. And finally, the object of the council is going to be as similar the object of your act, which we have referred to as AH8 objective, which we have studied in the start. So those should be the object of that particular district council. Moving ahead, talking about your state consumer protection council. Now this, every state is going to have a state council. Now the state council is been set up by your state government only, and it shall consist of, first of all, it is going to have a minister in charge, who will be the minister in charge of the consumer affair. Har state mein ek consumer affair se lekar ek minister hota hai. That particular minister will be called to be as a minister in charge of that particular consumer council, state consumer council, and that particular state government is going to appoint him as a chairperson or a chairman. Now, further along with him, he will have such number of official and non-official members representing him for the interest of the prescribed by the state government. So, जो काम आपको state government देता है, वो सारे ये representatives आपके साथ मिलके काम करने वाले हैं. आपके साथ means to say their chairperson के साथ मिलके. Now, further, he will have such number of other official and non-official members not exceeding 10. That means to say maximum 10 members who will be recommended and who will be appointed or nominated by the central government also. So state government ने जो आपको साथ appoint किए वो तो रहेंगे, but उसके अलावा भी आपके साथ central government ने जो appoint किए वो भी members आपके साथ work करने वाले हैं in the state council. Now, similar to your state district council, even the state council is going to meet at least minimum 2 meetings will be there in a year, and similar to the district council, even they are going to have similar objectives as been stated by the objective in the Act of the Consumer Protection Act. And even if you are going to pass any particular resolution, it is going to be the resolution as a recommendatory resolution and not the final order or the judgment. So whatever the recommendation will be given will be as a recommendatory statement by the state council also. And finally, we are going towards your central government or a central consumer protection council or a central council who are been appointed by the central government. Now the central government itself is having a minister in charge, and this minister in charge of the consumer affair will be called to be as a chairperson of the central council. Now the central council, along with the your minister or the chairperson, he will have such number of official and non-official members representing the interest of the particular consumer affairs, and the council will work as required by the central government, and their work will be as required for the necessary for the working of the consumer affairs. They will at least meet once in a year as when required by the chairperson. So chairperson ko jab bhi lagta hai koi severe cases and all hai, they are going to meet as required by them. And further, this council is going to pass the resolution. And whatever the council is going to pass the resolution is, again, it is going to be a recommendatory kind of resolution. And this council, again, they are having the same objective as objective stated in the Act. So basically, when we are talking about your state council, district council, and your central council, you have to understand who is the chairperson, how many times a year they are going to meet, what are the objectives they are going to have. So all they are going to have the similar objective. State and your district are going to meet twice a year minimum. Central is going to meet once a year. In case of your district council, the chairperson or the chair member is the district or collector. In case of your state and central, it is your minister of consumer affairs, and they are going to have such number of official and non-official members. And at the same time, in case of your state council, they are going to have additional, not more than 10 members who are been appointed by your central government. So this was your full-fledged chapter on your Consumer Protection Act of 1986. Thank you.